Hey there, folks. How we doing? It's 4:43 a.m. 12:16. I think it's still Wednesday. It was my last video. Yep. How about that? Three is about people, and 4:4 is strong fortitude. Four is fortitude, strong fortitude. Now it's 4:4:4. That's what I call the triple elders number. Fortitude. I don't use the term master's number because you have a master, you have a slave, and that's wrong. I've been that more than any of you. Anyway, whatever. People, don't let anyone walk on you, tell you what to do, control you. Okay? They'll push you, they'll yell at you, get in your face, they'll try to make you feel less confident of how you feel, because if they can do that, then that makes them feel more confident of who they are. You can't do this, you can't do that. Really? That's pretty wild. I've dealt with my share of control freaks, okay? A lot of them, especially in this business. Eventually, they need to be gone, from your life. The sooner the better. Okay. When I first started doing this, I would have people say, "Jay, I really want to represent you because you got something going here." Okay. And there's a big market out there, and no one does this stuff. So, I want you to talk more like this. I want you to dress like that. I want you to do this. And I'm like, okay. I'd let them talk and finish. And I said, "Is that really how you think this should be done?" And they say, "Yes." And I say, "Good. You do it that way." As you awaken, folks, this is your awakening, not theirs. Okay, if they want to give you some good advice, if they want to help you, and when they say good advice, it's something that worked for them and it's somebody you care about, someone you have some type of rapport with, great. Listen to them, it might fit you, it might not. But if they push it on you, they're trying to control you. Just tell them to shut the hell up. It's kind of simple. I'll be nice about it first, like the example I just gave you. But if they persist, usually I just laugh and leave. But sometimes it's a friend that's around a little bit, and you got to get a little stiff with them, okay? And tell them, "Look, I'm glad that works for you. I'm learning for myself, but this is me. This is me, my feeling, my abilities, my frequencies, which are different than yours. So, thank you for the advice." And just leave it there. Think it's stupid? Get a little stupider with them. Just hit them one shot in the face verbally. Verbally, not punch. Verbal. Bam, buzz off. And then turn around and leave. The best thing you can do to a pile of fertilizer is to walk away from it, okay? Again, common sense. Who needs that crap? I don't. How can you become yourself if someone else is telling you what to be? I don't know. I really don't. It's your journey. It's your awakening. It's your exploring. It's you, not them. They have all these different schools and thought processes and everything to do things. I understand that it's good to get a lot of knowledge any way you can. As a matter of fact, someone said, "Jay, who'd you get certified by?" And I'm like, this is a long time ago. And I said, "What?" They said, "Yeah, you supposedly this and this and that. Who certified you?" And I said, "The people that got the first certificate, the people that are certifying people, where'd they get theirs? If you follow it all the way back, someone just did it." Well, what do tell people to do? What's my school? My school is a school of you. It's the university of you, okay? The best teachers you could ever find are in your head. That's why I ask you to go inside yourself. Flow within so that you can flow without, you know, meaning out without your body, flow out of your body to flow without, okay? Just, you learn how to become yourself inside, touch to yourself, you know, just attach to yourself, touch yourself, feel yourself, and then you can start releasing yourself outwards. And then, see, the thing is, you want to take your conscious mind with you as you go. I wanted to do so much more stuff before I got out of here, and I've been doing whatever I could. Plus all the crazy souls on the other side running around, turning so many people around me upside down. It's crazy. But anyway, that's, you know, that's to be expected. When they're all gone, things will change. Some are going to stay the same, and some will be, you know, whatever. It's all going to be dealt with. That's all I'm trying to say. But there's a lot of people being bothered, and that's going to stop. Okay? That's part of the whole gig. My mop just won't reach over there from here to get rid of everything. And now that I'm over there, it's doing some stuff when it needs to. But it's like, I was talking to that part of me yesterday, and it's just, there's no time. We got to do this thing and come together. And we will, one way or the other. I don't back down from anything. I hope that you won't back down from one thing, becoming yourself, okay? Just please do that one thing. Take the time to relax and go inside yourself. If you want to learn different ways people do things, cool. That's wonderful. We're learning. It's an experience, okay? The more people you can talk to about things, you get a feeling, yes or no. Use all your abilities to feel. Maybe there's this much here that you keep and that much you throw away. Who knows? Maybe there's that much you keep and this much you throw away. Go ahead and explore it, but please, 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 you have to become yourself before you can be yourself. You have to go inside yourself to find yourself, to become yourself and be yourself. There's a lot of self in there, but it's got you and you're in front of it, okay? Simple. If you can relax and flow inside yourself, you're going to meet yourself. You're going to know more about yourself. You don't meet yourself like, hey, self, how you doing? Oh, good to see you. No, it's not like, Joey, right? Yeah, no. Not my imaginary friend Joey I made up for kicks. It's literally you relaxing, flowing inside yourself to feel. When you reach inside, when you relax, calm down, and flow down into yourself, it's just like feel your energy just floating down in yourself. It might feel like you're going down in your body. You're actually going to the hypothalamus in your brain, okay? Just relax and just feel it. Just feel in there. As you try to feel inside your brain, if you just calm the body down, take some extra, slightly deeper, natural, relaxed breaths and flow inside yourself. Remember, the mind, the conscious mind will be going like this, especially when we're solar plexus people, okay? Some solar plexus oriented people. Pull the two pins out and then let those gears, the conscious mind, those gears that keep turning, just see a set of gears coming off your head and floating up. Put them 10 feet away from you, 5 foot, just get them away, and then just relax. And then as you try to, as you relax and go into yourself, trying to feel or see what's inside you, most of us start with our eyes closed, okay? It's calmer. And then you go in there, and then you just start trying to feel. As you do that, you personally are setting your own brain waves to move in this direction. I'm sorry, I'm seeing something right now. whatever. excuse me. As you go to relax, some people call it meditation, call it what you want. I try to keep everything as simple as possible. The more simple it is, the easier it is to deal with. Okay? You just relax. Let your conscious mind float. Slightly deeper normal breaths. And just relax. And as you try to feel yourself, you are setting up your own personal brain in its own way to receive message. Once you can do that, and your ears will be ringing a lot, do whatever you want to do. But you know what? Don't waste money going to the doctor. If you have an earache, you have real serious pain, get the hell with a doctor. Okay? Get to the doctor immediately. But if it's just a ringing, folks, please leave it alone. That's your spirit guides working with you to adjust the frequencies within your ears. That what they're actually doing, what's actually happening, and no one will tell you this, they're physically taking, they're physically modifying the actual ear bone structure, inner ear and everything. They're physically changing it. Okay? So it vibrates different so you can hear them. There's no tuning adjustments in there. They're physically changing that part of your brain. Okay? It's different when you can see things the way I see it. You can see, when you can see for yourself, you have truth. Okay? And that's what this is all about. Once you can meditate and relax and talk with your spirit guides, man, you have, it's just like having some elders with you, but as far as elders, no, they're just like you, outside of the body. But they're out of the body. They're on the outside looking in, seeing all the stuff. They can tell you what's going on. They can tell you exactly, almost exactly, how to get through the next couple of days and information within the previous 2 days. Okay? They can't tell you the exact future, how it's going to happen, because it keeps changing. It's supposed to. How else can it be made to be better if it doesn't continually change? Again, just like me, simple. Okay? It's really important that you become yourself, because once you become yourself, you feel yourself, you learn how to feel your energy, the pineal, solar plexus, heart, understand your emotions, where they come from, and feel them. The more you relax and just feel your whole body and all your energy moving through, the more you become yourself. The more you can talk with your spirit guides, man, y'all are going to be kicking butt. Okay? They help you wake up, see things, and understand things. You see it for yourself. All these different places, these gurus and schools, a lot of them have this certain way to do this and do that and everything. They have a lot of helpful stuff that'll help you, okay? But you will never become yourself until you go inside yourself. And if you can't talk with your spirit guides yet, well, you know, and sometimes it's through message. Okay, so you can't, it's not always a voice. Sometimes, excuse me, sometimes it is. Sometimes it's an actual voice. I was trying to talk to my spirit guides when I started working, waking up. Blah, easy for me not to say. When I started waking up right away. And I said, all right, what's your name? And I got nothing. And I'm like, okay. And I don't know, honestly, I don't know if it was a day later or a week later, but I think it was at least a couple of days or something. I was in Costco having a slice of pizza. It's right down the road and it's super cheap. And back then I used to live off, pretty much live off of the samples that they had, that they gave away. And then all of a sudden, out of the right ear, I heard Robert. And I'm like, I knew it was talking to me. I could, in my head, I could see something over here saying Robert. Because I said, what's your name? And I got nothing. And then all of a sudden I'm relaxing, eating, and then boom. And I was like, and I'm looking around. It's like, say, who the hell said that? And there's no one looking at me. And I'm like, what the hell? And then I said, oh, I'll be damned. Because then I looked at my head and I saw a guy like Robert, like, you know, dude, hello. It's like, folks, that's what's important. It's about to be, next starting next year, it'll be easier for everyone to talk to your spirit guides. It's going to be made to be that. Because it's time for the third dimension over here and the other dimension, the second dimension. It's time for this open disclosure on this stuff, okay? The original first being wanted to hide everything. That's over now. They're dead. They're gone. Everything else will want to run everything except for all these stupid little souls going crazy everywhere. There's still hundreds of thousands of them. I can't I can't locate and kill them all, and we'll go back there in a minute. But anyway, this is being taken care of so that you can have new lives. Folks, you can have free will like you've never known. You can start having lives with your actual spirit mate, the other part, the other half of you, the actual other half. You have no idea how wonderful that is, okay? And guess what? They're not going to be tortured, and you won't be tortured. This abuse crap is over, and the physical bodies too. So, what's going to happen? Hey, I can't tell you until I'm myself, and I'm not myself when I'm stuck in this body. Okay, I can do some interesting stuff now with so much of my energy actually in this big body of energy of an arrow, because it now it's got it doesn't just have a focal point in it, I'm in it, so it's kind of weird. Again, things keep changing, but see, that's just the way it is. Isn't that what happens every day anyway? But what I really want you to do is please stop, relax, turn off your everything, shut down the iPad, just stop, get it calm. If you like a little soft music or something in the background, some walking water, running water, I like it walking, going a little slower, nice and soft. And it's weird how things come out of my mouth. But that's what I like. Is soft. It's like walking instead of the running. It's calm. Tom Kenyon sound bath. That's a nice one to relax. Excuse me. But anyway, what's really nice is to have quiet. But you have to calm your body down first. Those of you that like to work out, and hopefully there's a lot of you. You can't tell right now, but I used to love to work out. When I was in the military, I'd get bored and I'd knock out 600 sit-ups for something to do, a couple hundred push-ups, go out and run 20 miles. Now it's a joke. I get tired of watching someone else exercise. The benefits of degenerative joint disease and lung disease. Yes, good for you. Anyway, what do we call that too? Age. So anyway, if you work out and then get something back in you, okay, get some electrolytes and stuff in you, a little bit of fruit, whatever you feel you need, get it in you so you can relax. Because then your body's really calm. And then just have it quiet and just spend a little time relaxing. You don't have to work out before, I mean beforehand, but that's just one way that when I was younger, I would have, if I would have been doing this when I was younger, then that's how I would have had to do it because my energy level's always been through the roof, literally. So anyway, you are the only one who can awaken yourself. Number one. No school, no guru, no one can awaken you other than yourself. Okay? The barriers are gone. Almost all of you, everything's being fixed and about to be fixed where nothing can bother you. You have to calm down and go in yourself, contact your spirit guides, and then move forward from there. Going to a school to get information is good, keep the information, but if you're not yourself yet, what are you doing? If you're not able to relax and touch, go inside, and oh, people, it's only calming down. Your spirit guides are there waiting. And I've talked about animal essence, not coming back in bodies. Very, very, very little animal spirit, which is animal essence, is going back in bodies. Very little. Okay? When they're born, there's a whole lot of human souls and human essence going in bodies. Okay, some fae too. There's a male human essence energy in my neighbor's dog over there. They keep it outside all the time. I heard it bark and it sounded like a man, a man screaming, saying, "Let me in, I belong inside, let me in." And I'm like, "What the hell's going on?" And then I actually looked over there and I said, "Oh, okay." And it's a human soul. And he was never nice to his dog. Is that karma? Yeah. Yes, yeah, karma. That's serious karma. Someone being hurt physically, that's during their life and afterwards. But something that happens, like having a life as an animal, that's going to be abused the way you've abused them? Yeah, that's serious. Okay? I told you times are changing. They're going to keep changing. But the thing I really want to ask everyone to do is just become yourself. Okay? Relax, flow inside yourself, try to hear your spirit guides. You want to go to school or something like that? Cool. But at least try to find yourself. And don't try like this because you'll never get there. Breathing. Letting everything go. There's different ways to do that. Just feeling water coming down and soft, slow walking, not running, slow walking water just flowing slowly over yourself, and you take your energy and just let it flow right down to the ground. Okay, earthmagic.net, Stephen D. Farmer. He's got a free download there. It's called 4x4 Breath on his website, earthmagic.net. Okay. That'll help. But once you can talk with yourself, and once you can feel yourself and talk with your spirit guides that are in you, which is kind of like talking with yourself, but what I meant by that is you're walking around and you're talking with your spirit guides because they're with you. So, and you might not want to talk out loud because then people will say, "Okay, that person is talking to themselves." No, you're not. You're talking to your spirit guides. So then you have someone who can really help you, someone who's there to help you, who want to be there to help you all the time. When there's issues coming up with different people, the animal essence, their energy's changed now. All animal essence that's out of body, and as soon as the other stuff comes out, it gets the same treatment, has got this new mutated source energy that happened when I finally got rid of 99% of the original first being male and female. It just went weird. Something happened and almost knocked my friend Chivo out of the side of a chair. He's about 12 foot away, 10 foot away, whatever. So they have that now. Human essence and fae essence was really upset right away that they didn't get it. And it's like, tough, you don't deserve it. So the animals, they can move in and that stuff. They're super fast. They can't be hurt. I mean, yeah, I'm not going to hurt them, but they can't be hurt other than that. So they're sentinels. They go everywhere, and when there's an issue with spirit guides really not doing a good job, then Lily or I will know, and then they'll be replaced, not hurt or something stupid. Just the idea is for everything to start moving forward, and it has to be done from the other side. Okay, now over here, you have to wake yourself up by going inside yourself. You have to make the effort. Okay? It doesn't just happen. I go to sleep, I woke up, "Oh, I'm super psychic." No, it doesn't work like that, okay? You might want to consider using a metaphysical practitioner too. Whatever you want, that's cool. The only reason I say that is so many people that aren't awake are so adverse to the term psychic. And we understand so many of there's so many fakers out there. Whatever. Anyway, this awakening, your awakening is exactly that, yours. Okay? You need to do it yourself, but you need to not let other people tell you what to do. Okay? If you do, you'll be going in circles because let them give you advice. But the way you're going to find this is go inside yourself. Don't let anyone try to control you either. You have to do this, you have to do that. See how you feel about what others tell you, and then act accordingly to your own feelings. Okay? Whether I say it or someone else. I mean, isn't that the best way to be you? Trust yourself. Okay? I know who you are. Y'all are able to do a lot more than what you think. Okay? Well, once again, man, I love y'all. Happy hunting, finding yourself. That's the only kind of hunting I believe in. I don't like that word. It's nasty. You're in there. You're really cool. Please, find yourself. It's going to come through relaxing and trying to feel yourself inside. Close your eyes. Sometimes you get image, sometimes you get colors, sometimes you get a blank screen, and there's all kinds of ways to do this. Also, Dr. Brian L. Weiss is very good with the meditation thing, okay, and going into past lives. He's really cool. All right, man. Love y'all. Take care. Have a good one.